car drivers from all over the world have made an annual pilgrimage to Pittsburgh. They're part of something that does not take place anywhere else in the world, the Vintage Grand Prix. More than 160 passionate drivers taken hundreds of thousands of spectators back in time.
Sometimes they go more than 100 miles an hour, and it's not a regular race course, it's just Pittsburgh streets.
We don't have Monte Carlo here, but what we do have is we have the serpentine where the walls are, you know, right up against you, and the thrill of having that, those walls, you know, so close.
Vintage, pricey race cars doing their best in Pittsburgh rain.
This would be my good rain car, and if I'm lucky, it might rain while I'm driving this, but I'd like it to dry up very quickly when I go back out in this.
A constant threat, mechanical malfunction. Replacement parts are hard to come by.
I started to blow some smoke. I pitted in, took a look. They said, oh, everything looks okay. Did another lap, too much smoke. I probably blew a ring on the car. So I pulled it off and we're done for the weekend, unfortunately.
Of the 160 racers, about four of them are women, including Dottie Bechtel in her 1959 Elva Mark IV sports racer.
No, the boys really don't treat me any differently. Frankly, when I'm out there and I'm in my helmet, you don't know I'm a woman anyways.
They come from everywhere.
One gentleman here in pre-war brought a car all the way from California. It was a 40-hour drive for that man.
The reason? You just can't do this anywhere else.
And it's the longest running road course in the world next to Monaco. So there's a lot of history that comes here every year to Schenley Park. Very challenging. It's not built like a racetrack would be built. It's got a lot of concrete walls. It's got gutters.
Whether you finish first or you finish last, if you finish this race, you ought to have a really big smile on your face.
You're going more than 100 miles an hour on some of these city streets. Sounds like fun. Well, the money raised from the Vintage Grand Prix goes to the Allegheny Valley School and to the Autism Society of Pittsburgh.